Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Although the early ancestors of the American Staffordshire Terrier came from England, the development of the Amstaff was truly the development of an American breed. This type of dog was instrumental in the success of farmers and settlers who developed this wild country. The dogs were used for general farm work, hunting wild pigs, bears, and other large game. They guarded the homestead and were generally companion animals. Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV, and this is the YouTube channel for dog lovers. If you guys have not already, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. All right, in this video, I'm going to be doing a brief breed review of the American Staffordshire Terrier. The American Staffordshire Terrier's roots can be traced back to the 19th century of England. The bulldogs and terriers of the time were crossed to create a dog that possessed the desirable attributes of each breed. The result was an agile and energetic terrier with bulldog-like perseverance and confidence. Although the ancestors of the American Staffordshire Terrier were fighting dogs, the selective breeding since 1930s has been away from the fighting heritage, therefore making the American Staffordshire Terrier today more of a companion animal and a show dog, rather than a gladiator of its past. In 1936, the Amstaff was accepted for registration in the AKC stud books as the Staffordshire Terriers. The name of the breed was revised in January of 1972 to the American Staffordshire Terrier. Breeders in this country had developed this type of dog, which is a little bit heavier than the Staffordshire Bull Terrier of England, and the name change was used to distinguish them as separate breeds. The life expectancy for an Amstaff is 12 to 16 years. Temperament of this breed is tenacious, devoted, loyal, friendly, attentive, and courageous animal. The weight for females is going to be between 62 and 88 pounds, or 28 to 40 kilograms. Females are going to be between 17 and 18 inches high, 43 to 46 centimeters. For males, it's going to be about 62 to 88 pounds in terms of weight, and that's 28 to 40 kilograms. Males in terms of height will be between 18 and 19 inches, or 46 to 48 centimeters. Acceptable colors for the breed are black, brindle, fawn, sable, blue, and brown. In terms of my recommendation for this breed, I do not think the American Staffordshire Terrier is a breed for everybody, but I do believe that for the right person, the right family, this is an amazing breed, one of the more amazing dog breeds that I've come across. I personally love American Staffordshire Terriers. What I see from American Staffordshire Terriers is a certain love, commitment, loyalty, sometimes goofiness that you want in a family companion. If you're looking for a working dog, I don't necessarily know that you can find someone that's breeding these dogs for working purposes. My experience as of late has been more so around show dogs, which are less game, less animal aggressive. And quite honestly, I think that if you're looking for an American Staffordshire Terrier, you probably want, if you're looking to make it a pet, if you want to bring it into a pet home, you really want to make sure that you're looking at something on the less gamey side, because, you know, like the American Pit Bull Terrier, the Amstaff, if, you know, bred for animal aggression, can be very effective and efficient at tearing up other animals. But, you know, honestly, I wouldn't worry about that, because there's so many people right now breeding this dog for companionship. There's so many show breeders that are breeding these dogs with relatively very little health issues. The health issues, again, would probably be hip and elbow dysplasia. That's pretty much any dog. Other than that, if you're looking for an American Staffordshire Terrier, this is a dog breed where you want to do your research. You want to make sure that the person is breeding in a manner that is tailored to your intentions of ownership. Want a dog that's going to work, find a breeder who's breeding for working purposes. If you're looking to bring this dog into a pet home, which I think most of you probably will be doing, find someone that's breeding for temperament, and you're going to find yourself a great dog, a great family companion. All right, guys, good luck on your search, and I wish you guys all the best. This is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV. Peace.
your own style, that's just slang for you, ain't got it though. Talking like you got it, that's a problem, I might let them know. Tweet you like I'm lost or something, I look, let it go. Eeny, eeny, meeny, meeny, money, mo, head to toe. Said you got your own style, that's just slang for you, ain't got it.